to start tonight's show, we are going to look at that observatory that's down in Puerto Rico. In fact, a lot of you might not know we have an observatory there, a radio observatory, in this beautiful shot of Arecibo, which has suffered some problems. That was there where it was in good repair, here in less good repair after Hurricane Maria hit in 2017. And then here, April 10th, a big gash when one of the cables underneath broke and tore it open. And then we can move ahead here and take a look, and you can see some of the things Arecibo has been used for. Well, Mercury, you might think, what? It looked at a planet. Well, indeed, it actually measured the rotation of Mercury back in 1965. It was able to see ice at the bottom of craters on Mercury. So a fantastic result there. Here is the Crab Nebula. It saw the pulsar down in the Crab Nebula, or heard it in radio waves, and it actually discovered one of the first pulsars, or heard the very first pulsar. And this is actually what it sounds like. This is the first pulsar. Arecibo was used to do radar imaging of Venus, even, and so we saw the surface of Venus. It was able to do radar imaging of near-Earth objects, asteroids, as they flew by. We started to get pictures of them. This one's a little ghostly and difficult to see what's going on, but you can start to make out the shape of it. Arecibo was used to send a signal to the globular cluster M13. In fact, Frank Drake, was a professor of mine that taught me radio astronomy, sent this signal, and we're still waiting to hear anybody get back to us. Nobody has yet, but could there be aliens out there in M13 that are going to get that signal thousands of years from now? And maybe we'll hear back. I doubt it, but you never know. In fact, people tried to decode it. And the person that was most successful decoding it, believe it or not, was Carl Sagan. He got more of it right than any other single individual. He got a little chemistry, couldn't figure it out. But give it a try yourself. Download this online and see what you can make of it. And this is cheating to already have it be formed as a picture. You should get it as the dots and dashes, essentially, and you have to figure out how it repeats to build that picture. Of course, Arecibo is famous from film. This is Contact, the famous movie with Jodie Foster. And I always want to call him Owen Wilson. It's Matthew McConaughey, I know, but I love to get them confused. And I'm going to mock myself endlessly for confusing them now. It was in GoldenEye, I think this was, wasn't it? And James Bond film, and they did not treat Arecibo so well. I remember back in the day being upset in the theater that they blew up Arecibo. I thought that was unconscionable. Well, this leads us to what's actually happening with Arecibo here. And there's some video footage here that was taken just a few nights ago, a few days ago. It was in the morning, obviously. The camera monitoring it, and when the cable went back, it snapped. Incredibly damaged. And now this is the shocker. They were inspecting the cables with a drone the moment they snapped. You can see dust as the paint starts to come off, and boom. And the drone operator suddenly says, whoa, maybe I should look at the dish. And indeed, the last cable there snaps. And the drone operator's looking, what's going to happen? And tragedy, of course, has struck. The dish is that's not repairable. You cannot simply go in there and put in some new cables and fix it up. And this is the shots from above. You can see what we're dealing with. Arecibo is a mess right now, and it makes you wonder, what is the future for Arecibo? We can hope that someday it'll be back, and it'll be back observing. Now, of course, it can observe during the day as well as at night. And there is already a push to save the Arecibo Observatory. And you can find these folks on social media. There are folks that live on Puerto Rico, astronomers that are there.
We can rebuild
Arecibo.
We have the technology.
And should we build it maybe bigger than it was before?
Better, stronger.
And my dog agrees, of course, as well.